You know, Congressman, we've been following this very closely because, like you, we're also very concerned about what had happened there. So that's the situation before this the tragedy even struck, that it was supposed to be a no-build zone. But days before, even hours before the tragedy struck, there should have been a mechanism in place, correct, to inform that there might just be a landslide that may happen, because these are things that can be predicted because of the saturation of the soil, for example, because of incessant rains. Would you know if there was something that was done of that sort, like informing the residents there that they should evacuate?
That's what we want to find out tomorrow in our committee hearing investigation, Mr. Mina. Pero as far as I was informed, wala daw, even the LGU, even the barangay level, nobody informed the people there na mag-evacuate na kayo. Walang nag-informed daw sa kanila. So we really have to investigate. Kailangan natin malaman. That's why we invited the LGU, the DNR, and the MGB, sila mismo. Bakit hindi kayo nagsabi? Why didn't you warn them? Everybody, the PNP, where were they, Ms. Carmina? Before or hours before that incident, where were they? The DNR, MGB, the LGU, the PNP, saan po sila? 98 po yung patay. Hindi yun natin pwedeng ipikit yung ating mga mata. We can't.
So when you ask yourself that question, and when you look at the images we're showing our viewers right now, the aftermath of that landslide, what answer comes to mind? Where was government before, during, and even after the tragedy, Congressman?
That's the question that I want to find out tomorrow, Ms. Carmina. That's why this investigation starting tomorrow. Saan? Pero we already know at this point, Ms. Carmina, common sense will tell us na there was an order, subalit hindi sinunod. There was an order, hindi in-implement fully by the MGB, by DNR. My order, my instruction, but the LGU did not comply. So, and strictly enforce it. My PNP naman, my military doon siguro sa lugar, but we'll just leave it hanggang sa LGU. Where were they? That is the question we want to ask tomorrow, Ms. Carmina.
But ultimately, though, who should be responsible here?
I believe it's the LGU. I believe it's the LGU and the MGB. Diyan ko nakikita yung dalawa na yan. Because the LGU, alam niya na no-build zone. Since 2008, Ms. Carmina, the instruction or the order was given last 2008, because there was already a landslide during that time. So MGB came up with the order that this area here will be a no-build zone. How come there were still houses there? They should have cleared that area. And MGB should have enforced it and really should have told the LGU, bawal po dyan, Mayor, alisin niyo na yung mga tao. But they did not insist. Siguro money talks, Ms. Carmina.
Why do you say siguro money talks? What led you to say that, Congressman?
There's a mining firm there, Ms. Carmina. There's a mining firm, and most of these people are staying in that area, okay? So baka tinapalan yung mata ng MGB, tinapalan yung mata ng DNR, and particularly, especially, the LGU. Kaya the houses were still there, despite the fact that there was already an order that is a no-build zone.
Are you also going to call officials of the mining company?
Definitely. We will have to invite them, Ms. Carmina.
A while ago, you said that ultimately you hold the LGU and the MGB responsible for this. If the MGB back in the early 2000s have already said that this is a no-build zone, this is a no-go zone, should they have stopped at that? Should they have, because they might just tell you that, Congressman, that we already gave, you know, our findings and we already gave our order. Go ahead.
I won't buy that, Ms. Carmina. I mean, they shouldn't have stopped there. When they gave the order, they should have made sure that order should have been implemented and followed by the LGU, by the residents, by the mining firm. Dapat sinunod yung instruction. Because buhay ng tao yun eh. 90, dahil dyan, 98 lives were lost, Ms. Carmina.
Pagkatapos ngayon, Katulad nga nung sinabi niyo, it's been almost a month, right? More than a month, actually, since the tragedy happened. What are the expectations of the DENR at this point? What should they be doing?
They should have already filed charges, Ms. Carmina. They should have already filed cases against the LGU, against the officials, the municipal planner, the mayor, the council, everybody, Ms. Carmina, and they should have already asked MGB how come the order was not implemented properly, or nobody followed that instruction or order that they gave in 2008. Dapat sila yung nanguna, Ms. Carmina. Sila yung spearheading this investigation. Dapat sila na nagkaso sa ombudsman.
And because there is this seeming silence coming from the DENR, what does that tell you, Congressman?
In my own opinion, I believe money talks.
Still,
I mean, why? Bakit kayo yung in charge their Department of Environment and Natural Resources? This is environment, di ba? Natural resources. Bakit ayon yung kumilos? Bakit 98 ang patay, 98 died, and you don't want to move or lift a finger? What? Why wait for Congress? Hindi po namin trabaho mag-imbestiga na mag-imbestiga. Our job in Congress and in Senate to pass laws, not to investigate primarily. Pero ganun na nangyayari because DNR doesn't want to move, doesn't want to lift a finger, or MGB, Ms. Carmina.
All right. And as you said, Congressman, you're going to start the investigation tomorrow. But as we speak, I think any moment from now, the deliberations on the economic provisions of the Constitution, the amendments to that, that's going to begin as well. And that's going to happen within, I think, 3 days. That, at least that's the plan. Let's shift to that, Congressman Tulfo. What are your expectations from the deliberations on the economic provisions of the Constitution that are seeking to be amended, Congressman?
I believe, we have already passed that. There will be deliberations within the next few days, and after which, and I'm confident that it will pass Congress. It will be reconciled, both houses of Congress, the upper chamber and the lower chamber. But then again, the ball is now in the hands of the Senate, Ms. Carmina.
We do know that there are three articles, right? That want to be amended. But here's the thing, dun pa lang sa entrada, yung voting jointly or separately, mukhang nagkakaiba po. Kasi halimbawa po, si Speaker Martin Romualdez, he stopped at saying that, upon 3/4 vote of the House, voting of all the members, hindi po ba? Pero doon naman sa resolution ng Senado, it states that upon a vote of 3/4 of all its members, with each house voting separately. That's very explicit right there. But RBH 7, I think, is silent on that. Do you think that doon pa lang magkakatalo na po? Paano, what's going to happen if there are going to be differing recommendations coming from both houses of Congress, Congressman?
Yes, there'll be a stalemate. I mean, I'm a neophyte, Ms. Carmina, and I would love to see that that day. What's going to happen? Kagaya ho ninyo, I want to see that. Pero we're standing by. One congressman even raised that issue because on the very first day of this committee of the whole last week, one congressman raised about the voting separately. He asked, is it in the Constitution? Somebody said, no, it's just a resolution of the Senate. It should be the House should always vote together, not separately. Mm-mm. Both houses.
Mm-hmm. So how do you think that's going to end?
I don't know. Mm-hmm. This is my first year in Congress. I mean, I haven't seen this kind of incident, a situation yet. I want to see, and I want to learn from the veterans, veteran lawmakers.
Yeah. Pero sana naman, Congressman, hindi ba? Parang whatever happens, sana ang taong bayan ang panalo. This is not a tussle between the upper chamber and the lower house. That either will win at the end of the day. Go ahead.
All I'm praying right now is just that everybody moves on. whatever the decision, whatever the people would like, that's where I am. After all, we are all representatives of the people. We're supposed to echo the voice of the people. And then kung ayaw ng public yun, why force it, diba? But if the public wants it, then so be it.
Halimbawa yung sa education, Congressman, while we have you, and this is going to be the final question. Education, halimbawa, you want to lift the restrictive provisions of the education sector. Ang sabi ng iba, higher education, that's fine. But what we fail to see here is that if the restrictions are lifted and you have all these foreign educational institutions coming in, might that be sort of a way to siphon off the capital from the local institutions at doon mapunta? Might that not lead to the death or to the detriment of the standing local institutions that we have, Congressman?
As a matter of fact, it will be a competition. It will be a challenge for our local schools here because walang iniwan po yan na Ms. Carmina sa tindahan. Those who can afford, those who can buy, quality products or in this case education, have the money to spend. Wala, parang between public din and private, Ms. Carmina. Public because walang pera yung magulang. Private because may pera. Ngayon, if papasok yung mga foreign schools, then kung may pera sila, then go, di ba?
Pero hindi ba, wouldn't that, once again, widen the gap between the rich and the poor, that those who have can afford while those who don't will be stuck in the rut?
It's just like this, Ms. Carmina, yung public and private. Then if you're saying like na wala na magiging gap between the poor and the rich, then let's just shut down a private school. Because decision ng family, ng tao, kung saan, meron namang yung choice, di ba? We have the freedom of to choose where to send our kids. It's just like also the freedom of religion. Kung anong gusto mong religion, then you practice that. Same thing with education. Gusto ko yung anak ko sa private school. Yung iba naman who cannot afford, then they're left out to public institutions. That's what I said. So, then I guess siguro... We'll just leave it to the public, yung kanilang choice, Ms. Carmina, kung saan nila pag-aaralin yung kanilang anak.
Yeah, but how do you then reconcile that with the fact that as we speak, there are a lot of institutions who have partnerships with institutions outside of the country, and they are strengthening their local curriculum via these partnerships? Hindi na kinakailangan pa na baguhin yung konstitusyon kasi may partnership naman po with other institutions abroad. Kaya naman po.
Well, that I also want to see, Ms. Carmina. So there will be deliberations by next week. I want to participate there, and I really want to listen. During that committee of the whole for the past 2 weeks, I was there. I was attending every day. I really want to learn, and I want to learn more. So that's very interesting during the deliberation. I want to hear both sides, Ms. Carmina. And kung saan yung gusto ng tao, then I will go with that, Ms. Carmina.
All right, we're going to have to leave it at that. Congressman Erwin Tulfo there joining us this noon. Thanks again for taking our call.
Thank you. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon to you.